Hello, brothers and sisters in Christ. This is Sunday, and it's January 12th, 9:23 a.m. Excuse me. I don't know if I got this in my email, or I think I just, it was just on the side, as in recommended for you. I'm pretty sure that's where I found it. Anyway, it's called Bill Johnson's Theology and Movement Examined Biblically. Oh my goodness. I am like just shaking my head thinking this man, let's see what his channel name is. Mike Winger. Not familiar with him either. But what he's, I've listened to 32 minutes out of an hour and 19. He says he has listened to thousands of hours of Bill Johnson's videos. And he said he has been highly, what did he put it, like I was saying yesterday, how I was so impressed with that message, and I wanted to share it, and I got a lot out of it. Well, he was saying that he too got a lot out of it. He enjoyed a lot of the teaching tremendously, but he found error in a lot of it also. And he's pointing out a lot of them. For those of you who like Bill Johnson and didn't understand me pulling the video, or you would just like to know more in case you find somebody else sharing Bill Johnson or his church's Bethel church, or anything about the Jesus culture music that came out of this church. Okay. You might want to put it in your, I don't know what column you'd put it in, but he's showing clips of things that Bill has taught that are so anti-biblical, against the word, saying he's all about Jesus, and if, like he's saying, Father is has passed judgment, but Jesus brought mercy. So even though Father was right, Jesus is more right. Well, let me tell you something. Jesus brought mercy, but there's still judgment, and they're not one above the other. They're equal. We still have to live right, okay? How many times do I have to say it? You still have to obey the gospel, gospel truths, the words Jesus laid down in his gospel for us to do, how to love one another, how to forgive as we're forgiven, and so forth. He gives so many examples of the right way for us to live and respond to a poor person, or to a sick person, or to someone beaten up the street, as in the story of the Good Samaritan. And people think it's wrong to believe we need to do good works. Oh boy, our good works alone cannot get us into heaven. For sure, we have to accept Jesus as our personal Savior. We have to confess our sins, admit we're a sinner, and confess those sins. Ask Jesus into our hearts, and ask him to follow up with filling us with the Holy Spirit. I mean, there are certain things you have to do. You can't just believe, because even the demons believe and tremble when we start using the name of Jesus, because they know they got to go. Okay, so I'm going to put I'm going to link this. I was going to let you listen to a few of the examples, but if you're interested, you can listen to it. I'll put, if you want to hear it and can't get the description box to show up, it's Mike Winger. And this is called Bill Johnson's Theology and Movement Examined Biblically. Okay. With this, I'll say I plead the blood of Jesus over the internet connection. Oh, let me show you. This was one of my new sweatshirts that I was able to get. And it's I used my paint pens on it. It is not about religion. It's about relationship. Colorful, huh? This should catch an eye or two. This is my Jesus First pen. I found it yesterday when I was putting up my decorations and snowflakes and nativity scenes. And I still have one hanging over there and my snowman over here, but I'll get to them later. I'm really wore out. Doesn't take much. Anyway, I'll plead the blood of Jesus over this video and the internet connection and over each and every one of you and your devices and your internet connections and over my computer so we can stay connected. And until Jesus comes back. And just one little thing I wanted to mention. I could understand a couple of people maybe leaving, unsubscribing because I screwed up twice in 1 week. I keep asking the Holy Spirit to please remind me to research all sources before I share something. I asked him to remind me, and I forgot. I was so built up by the message, I was anxious to share it. So you would be built up. But can we listen to somebody? Because half of their messages will build us up when the other half could put you down the wrong path? I don't think so. So, I ask you to forgive me for sharing that, even though that one sermon to me was excellent. You see? This man is very gracious in how he goes about doing this. Not mean. He's not mean-spirited. He is simply exposing this man and his church and the apostolic movement because it's worldwide now. And this is why we all need to know our sources. Okay? Let us all learn from this. If you start following anybody that you really like, if it's a big, they got thousands of subscribers, you might want to research them. Because usually that means they're candy coating something. The world likes them. That's usually a really big... what's the word I want? Red flag. Now, this guy has 107,000, but it may be because of what he does. I don't know. Should I have researched him? I'm telling you, I don't have it in me to do it. I will do the best I can. How about that? All right. With that, I'll say bye for now. I will talk to you later.